University Challenge. Asking the questions, Jeremy Paxman.
Hello. Tonight we pass the halfway mark of our gruelling quarter-final stage. 7 of the 8 teams that began this ordeal remain in the running for the trophy after back-to-back defeats saw Birmingham leave the competition last time. Both tonight's teams, however, won their first quarter-final, and whoever wins again tonight will take the first spot in the semis. Now, the team from the University of Reading have an unblemished record up to now. They won comfortably against the universities of Strathclyde in round one and Dundee in round two, before just about coming out on top against Birmingham University in a hard-fought first quarter-final. Alert viewers may notice a change in their lineup since then, however, with their reserve member Ms Bishop playing tonight, with an accumulated score of 590 points from these three matches and an average age now of 38. Let's meet the Reading team again.
Hi, I'm Sylvian Jesuthas. I'm originally from Tanjore, Tamil Nadu, India, and I'm doing PhD in marketing.
Hi, I'm Margaret Ounsley. I live in Reading and I'm studying for a PhD in poor law history.
This is their captain.
Hi, I'm Michael Hutchinson from Andover. I've recently graduated with a PGCE and I'm now a fully fledged teacher.
Hi, I'm Kira Bishop. I'm from Slough and I'm studying maths and psychology.
Their opponents, Imperial College London, have been metronomically consistent so far, winning all three of their matches with a score of more than 200 points. They beat fellow quarter-finalists St John's College, Cambridge, in the first round before seeing off Exeter University in the second, and in their first quarter-final, proving rather too much for King's College London, with 650 points from three matches and an average age of 22. Let's meet the Imperial team again.
Hi, I'm Max Tung. I'm from Singapore and I study biochemistry.
Hi, I'm Fatima Sharif. I'm from Hitchin in Hertfordshire and I'm studying for a Master's in Science Communication.
And their captain?
Hi, I'm Michael Mays. I live near Montrose in Angus and I'm studying a PhD in Computational Fluid Dynamics.
Hi, I'm Gilbert Jackson. I'm from Bury St Edmunds in Suffolk and I study chemistry.
OK, you all know the rules by now, so let's just get on with it. Fingers on the buzzers, here's your first starter for 10. What five-letter word begins expressions with these meanings? A statistical measure of student enrolment in education, a standard measure of the value of goods and services produced in a country during a certain period...
And Reading Ounsley.
Gross.
Gross is correct. Well done. You get the first set of bonuses. They're on etymologically unrelated words that begin with the same three letters. In each case, give the word from the definition. Firstly, a modern-day country of the Americas whose territory was the target of the ill-fated 17th-century colonisation project known as the Darien Scheme.
Darien Scheme is Panama, I think.
P-A-M.
Yeah, Panama.
Panama is correct. A term coined in 1791 by the Irish-born artist Robert Barker to describe his large landscape paintings intended to be exhibited in 360 degrees on a cylindrical wall.
Panorama.
Oh, panorama.
Panorama.
Correct. Derived from the Malay language, a group of nocturnal armoured mammals of the order Pholidota, sometimes called the scaly anteaters.
Pangolin.
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 Correct. Yeah. Right, another starter question. With fewer than 30 copies still known to exist, the Dunlap broadsides are contemporaneously printed versions of which historical document?
Reading Hutchinson.
American Declaration of Independence.
That's correct, yes. You get a set of bonuses this time on a 19th century novel. Which novel of 1848 concludes with the words, "Come, children, let us shut up the box and the puppets, for our play is played out." Its subtitle is A Novel Without a Hero.
It's Vanity Fair.
Vanity Fair.
Correct.
Good one.
Vanity Fair features a ball in Brussels on the eve of which military engagement? Along with the Battle of Ligny, it is one of two preliminary battles to the Battle of Waterloo.
What is it, sorry?
Oh, preliminary battles of Waterloo.
Yeah, preliminary to Waterloo.
I don't know. Battle of Bruges,
Battle of Bruges.
That's the Battle of Quatre Bras. And finally, described as a disrespectful playboy, which of the novel's characters is killed at the Battle of Waterloo? He shares his name with the former Chancellor of the Exchequer.
George Osborne.
George Osborne is correct. 10 points for this. What planetary satellite has a distinctive network of dark cracks across its otherwise bright surface and a scarcity of impact?
Imperial Jackson.
Europa.
Europa is correct. Right, your bonuses are on a platonic solid. Plato's dialogue Timaeus assigns elements to 4 of the 5 regular platonic solids, except which one with the Schlafly symbol, brackets 5-3?
5-3.
Like, it's like octahedrons or like...
go with an octahedron, maybe.
5-3. It's made of like triangles and pentagons. So what's that called?
Just go with the octahedron.
No, it's like dodecagon?
No, it's dodecahedron. Bad luck. In his Mysterium Cosmographicum, Kepler fitted platonic solids between the orbits of the known planets. Which two were separated by the dodecahedron?
Oh, my. So it would have to be the... Saturn and Uranus.
No, it was Uranus, no, in there.
Oh, no, it's OK. Jupiter and Saturn, because the distance, maybe.
Jupiter and Saturn?
No, it's Earth and Mars. How many direct symmetries does a regular dodecahedron have?
I mean, 12's in the name, but...
I mean, go with...
Regular around the pentagon, 5 or 12 or something.
Go with 12.
It's too obvious. 12.
No, it's 60. Okay. We're going to take a picture around now. Your picture starter, you're going to see a coat of arms of a European country's navy. For 10 points, I want you to identify the country.
Imperial Zeng.
Italy.
Italy is correct. Each quarter of the shield on the Italian Navy's coat of arms represents one of the maritime republics that once dominated the Mediterranean. 5 points for each republic you can name from the quarter of the shield that represents it. Firstly, this maritime republic?
That's Genoa.
Genoa.
It is. Secondly?
This one's either Pisa or Amalfi. Go with Amalfi.
Amalfi?
No, you should have gone with Pisa.
I like it.
And finally?
Venice.
Yeah, Venice.
Venice is correct. Well done. 10 points for this. In mythology and fiction, what particular attribute is said to be granted by all of the following? The cap or helmet of the Greek god Hades.
Reading Armsley.
Invisibility.
Invisibility is correct. These bonuses are on opera. Meaning compartment or division, what short German term is used for a system of voice classification used to distinguish operatic roles?
Any ideas?
Nope.
No, pass.
That's Fach. What term is used in the Fach system for an elaborate soprano role characterized by trills and cadenzas? A notable example occurs in the so-called mad scene of Donizetti's Lucia di Lammermoor.
Colorata? Is that something?
Right.
Colorata.
No, it's coloratura. First played by Mozart's sister-in-law, Josefa Hofer, which coloratura soprano role in the Magic Flute sings the aria known as the Revenge of Hell?
Queen of the Night.
Queen of the Night is correct. 10 points for this. Answer as soon as your name is called. I need a 2-digit number. Of the 7 letters used in Roman numerals, 3 appear consecutively on a standard QWERTY keyboard. Taken in order, what decimal number does this combination represent?
Imperial Jackson.
56.
Anyone want to buzz from Reading?
Reading Hutchinson.
1,049.
No, it's 95. Right, we're going to take another starter question now. What island is this? A leading producer of vanilla and sapphires. It is a little...
Reading large. Hutchinson.
Madagascar.
Madagascar is correct. Well done. 3 questions on the zoologist Diane Fossey. In 1967, Fossey established the Karisoki Research Centre for the Study of Gorillas in the Virunga Mountains region of which country?
I think it's Rwanda.
Yes.
Yeah? Rwanda?
Rwanda is correct. Secondly, born in Kenya in 1903, which anthropologist was an early mentor of Diane Fossey and to the scientists Birute Galdikas and Leakey. Jane Goodall? Louis Leakey is correct. Following Fossey's murder in 1985, the conservation fund she had founded was renamed in her honour. Which actress became its honorary chair in 1988?
Is that going to be Sigourney Weaver? She played her in the film.
Yeah.
Sigourney Weaver.
Sigourney Weaver is correct. 10 points for this. Charlotte, Countess of Yarmouth, Charles Lennox, Duke of Richmond, and James Scott, Duke of Monmouth, were among the illegitimate children of which British...
Imperial Maze.
Charles II.
Charles II is correct. Your bonuses this time are on mathematics and physics. From an Italian Renaissance family, what name is given in topology to a system of three loops connected so that cutting any one loop leaves the other two unlinked?
I think I've maybe heard this once before, but... Italian Renaissance family.
Because it's going to be Visconti, Sforza, Borromeo.
No, but I think mathematical Renaissance family.
Medici?
Maybe like Cardano or...
You're going for something.
Cardano?
No, it's Borromean rings or links. Similar in idea to a Borromean linkage, a system of subatomic particles in which a group of three is stable but a pair is not, is named after which Soviet theoretician?
It could be Lev Landau or... like, he's Soviet and a theoretician.
Go with that, then.
Yeah.
Go with Landau.
Yeah.
Landau?
No, it's Efimov. And finally, observed in red giant stars, the triple alpha process features what specific isotope as a short-lived intermediary state?
Is that going to be, like, tritium?
Could be tritium.
No, but red giants.
I'm lying. I'd go tritium.
OK.
Tritium.
That's beryllium-8. Oh. Right, 10 points for this starter question. Sciagraphy is a branch of the science of perspective that deals with the projection of what?
Reading Hutchinson.
Elections?
No. You lose 5 points and you can hear the rest of it, everybody else. In less common usages, the term may also refer to the science of radiography and to the making of sundials.
Imperial Sharif.
Chronology?
No, it's shadows. Right, 10 points for this. The White Boy Shuffle and The Sellout are works by which...
Imperial Sharif.
Paul Beattie.
Paul Beattie is correct. Well done. Your bonuses are on the so-called coloured cities of the Indian state of Rajasthan. In each case, name the city from the description. Firstly, the city nicknamed the Pink City after its ruler ordered buildings to be repainted pink, the colour of hospitality, before a visit by the Prince of Wales in 1876.
Is this Jodhpur or Jaipur? Jodhpur is the blue city, I think, so Jaipur would be the pink city.
Jaipur.
Jaipur is correct. Distinguished by its yellow sandstone architecture, the city known as the Golden City, secondly. It is dominated by a medieval fort noted for its appearance when viewed at sunrise and sunset.
I don't know, this could be Udaipur or Ajmer or Bikaner or...
Just take a guess. Something dominated by a big fort. The fort must be famous, so...
Let's go with Bikaner.
Bikaner?
No, it's Jaisalmer. Nicknamed the Blue City after the buildings in its old quarters, which city is situated on the edge of the Thar Desert?
Jodhpur.
Yeah, Jodhpur.
Jodhpur is correct. 10 points for this. A single word is sufficient here. Also known as a reduction division, what is the term for nuclear division during the formation of gametes?
Imperial Tsung.
Meiosis.
Meiosis is correct, yes. Right, your bonuses are on popes this time. In each case, identify the regnal name shared by the following. Firstly, the second who gave his blessing to the Norman conquest of England, and the sixth, the father of Lucrezia Borgia.
Alexander, yeah.
Alexander.
Correct. Secondly, the third, who decreed the second and final excommunication of Henry VIII, and the sixth, who concluded the Second Vatican Council in 1965.
Clement.
So 1965 would be Paul VI, right?
Yeah.
So Paul.
Yeah, because it's too early for John Paul I, isn't it?
Yeah.
And we've obviously died.
Paul.
Paul VI. Oh, Paul. Paul.
Paul is correct. And finally, the eighth, who put Galileo on trial, and the second, who launched the First Crusade.
Urban.
Urban, yeah.
Urban.
Urban is correct. We're going to take a music round now. Your music starter, you're going to hear a piece of classical music. For 10 points, please name the composer.
Imperial Jackson.
Saint-Saëns.
Saint-Saëns is correct. Well done. That was part of Carnival of the Animals, including a parody of his own Danse Macabre. Your music bonuses are three works by other composers that are quoted or parodied in the Carnival of the Animals. Name the composer of each, please. First quoted in The Elephant.
Mendelssohn.
Mendelssohn.
Mendelssohn is correct. Secondly, again quoted in Fossils.
But the thing is, it sounds like Rossini, but I know Rossini is the oh no, it's Can-Can is the Offenbach one that they'll play next. So I think this is Rossini.
Okay.
Rossini?
Rossini is correct. And finally, parodied in Tortoises.
Yeah.
Offenbach.
Offenbach is correct, yes. Right, 10 points for this. What present-day European country suffered three partitions in the later 18th century?
Imperial Zeng.
Poland.
Poland is correct. Right, three bonuses on faked correspondence. In 1972, the US novelist and journalist Clifford Irving was convicted of forging letters in order to be commissioned to produce an autobiography, also fake, ostensibly of whom?
Have you heard of this? I've not heard of this.
What time was it?
1972. A fake biography.
Fake biography of someone who would be worth faking.
Like Shakespeare or someone, I don't know.
Honestly, like, what?
Yeah, sure. Shakespeare.
That was Howard Hughes.
Oh. Okay.
Which 8th century forgery claimed to be a historical document transferring control of the Western Roman Empire to the papacy under Sylvester
I? Isn't it the Donation of Constantine?
Go with that.
The Donation of Constantine?
Correct. And describing the fabrication of a series of emails, the song Sincerely Me comes from which musical, the winner of a Tony Award in 2017?
Sincerely Me. It's not like Dear Evan
Hansen. Oh, wait, is it Dear Evan Hansen? Because it's about
Dear Evan Hansen.
Yeah.
Dear Evan Hansen.
It is Dear Evan Hansen, yes. Well done. 10 points for this. For a three-dimensional wave function in quantum mechanics, what quantity is obtained using the operator minus I?
Imperial Maze.
The Hamiltonian.
No. You lose 5 points. What quantity is obtained using the operator minus I H bar grad?
Reading Hutchinson.
Lagrangian.
No, it's linear momentum. Right, 10 points for this starter question. What six-letter word is used for both the verdigris-like layer that develops on the surface of weather...
Imperial maze.
Patina.
Patina is correct, yes. These bonuses are on critical terms. All three answers are two-word terms with the first word in common. Which branch of literary theory was developed principally by Stephen Greenblatt in the 1980s? It encouraged a return to analysing texts in relation to the context of their production.
I want to say it's like new something, like...
Or like historical or something.
It's either like new historicism or new...
Do you want to go with that? Because
I think it's wrong. I think historicism is wrong, but... New historicism?
That is correct.
Well done.
What English name is usually given to the realist art movement associated with Otto Dix and Georg Grötz?
New objectivity.
Which emerged in Germany in the 1920s as a reaction against expressionism.
New objectivity.
Yeah.
New objectivity.
That is correct. Influenced by writers such as Jane Jacobs and focusing on cities, what name is typically given to the design movement that advocates compact, mixed-use building development with an emphasis on walkability?
Presumably it's new something.
Sustainable cities, I think.
Presumably it's
new something.
Sustainability?
New sustainability.
Do you have anything?
No. Like, we have nothing.
I should know this, but I don't.
New sustainability?
No, it's new urbanism.
Okay.
10 points for this. In 1689, which two empires signed the Treaty of Nechinsk?
Imperial Zeng.
Russian Empire, Qing Empire.
That is correct, yes, Russia and China. Right, you get a set of bonuses on transuranic elements. In each case, identify the element from its anagram. Nine tenses is an anagram of the name of which transuranic element, the heaviest of the halogens?
Tennessine.
Yeah, tennessine.
Tennessine.
Tennessine is correct. Umber-like is an anagram of the name of which transuranic element named after a city in California?
Berkelium.
Berkelium.
Berkelium is correct. Finally, minute pun or minute pun is an anagram of the name of which actinide metal with the atomic number 93?
93 is neptunium.
Yeah.
Neptunium.
Neptunium is correct. We're going to take our second picture round now. For your picture starter, you will see a still from a documentary film. For 10 points, please name the musician pictured.
Reading Hutchinson.
Simone.
Yes, it's Nina Simone. Well done. That image of her was from Amir Thompson's 2021 documentary Summer of Soul about the 1969 Harlem Cultural Festival, a Black Pride event attended by nearly 300,000 people. Your bonuses are three more stills from this documentary. I want you to name the performer in each case. Firstly, this front man.
Oh, is that Little Richard or somebody?
I nominate you. Nominate Ansley.
Is it Little Richard?
No, it's Sly Stone. Secondly, this blues musician.
Should I just go B.B. King?
Yeah.
B.B. King?
B.B. King is correct. And finally, name either this group or just their lead singer.
Jackson 5?
No, it's not. It's...
And the Pips.
Gladys Knight and the Pips.
Yeah, Gladys Knight.
Gladys Knight and the Pips is correct, yes. Well done. 10 points for this starter question. What surname is shared by two contemporaneous US composers, one of whom wrote the score for the film The Magnificent Seven, and the other the music for West Side Story?
Imperial Sharif.
Bernstein.
That is correct. Your bonuses are on 20th century poets in the words of Seamus Heaney. In each case, identify the poet from the description. Firstly, in the late 20s and early 30s, he caught native English poetry by the scruff of the neck, pushed its nose sharply into modernity. This poet died in 1973.
It sounds like Eliot.
Yeah, it does sound like Eliot.
No, it's W.H. Auden.
Oh.
Her last poems represent themselves with all the pounce and irrefutability of a tiger lashing its tail. This poet died in 1963.
So, that's Sylvia Plath, right?
Yeah. Plath.
Correct. Finally, his poetry is as redolent of the lair as it is of the library. This poet died in 1998.
Oh, the guy who was in the library, not Heaney, you know, the guy Larkin or something. Didn't he work in a library?
Oh, yeah, Philip Larkin. Did. Yeah, I think you're right. And I think he probably died in there. Yeah.
Larkin?
No, it's Ted Hughes.
Well.
10 points for this. Distinguished by large cheek pouches, what old world primate genus includes the snow monkey of Japan, the Barbary ape, and the rhesus
Imperial monkey? Jackson.
Macaque.
Macaque is correct. These bonuses are on fortresses. A centre of cheese making, which town near Cardiff is home to Britain's largest castle after Windsor?
Is that like.
Town near Cardiff? Newport is a city, Barry or Merthyr Tydfil or...
Do you know any of the big castles?
Castles?
No, not at all, so...
Do you have any idea? Or, just give me a guess.
Go, like, Barry, I don't know.
Barry?
No, it's Caerphilly.
Okay.
Meaning fortress or stronghold, Caer, that's C-A-E-R, is the Welsh name of which English city, a former Roman legionary base?
Is that going to be Chester?
Oh, yeah, Chester was the centre of the Welsh marches, so yeah.
Chester.
Chester is correct. The legionary fortress of Caerleon is situated on the River Usk, a few miles from which Welsh city?
Newport, I would assume.
River Usk. It's near River Usk.
Sorry?
It's near the River Usk.
Yeah.
Newport, you said. Newport.
Newport is correct, yes. Right, 10 points for this. Of the elements of the P for Papa block of the periodic table, which has the lowest atomic number?
Imperial Tsung.
Boron.
Boron is correct. These bonuses are going to be on apples in fine art.
Ooh.
Still Life with Apples and Basket of Apples are works by which artist born in Provence in 1839?
Cezanne.
present is correct. Which artist's painting Swallows the Poisoned Apple depicts Walt Disney's Snow White as a middle-aged woman clutching her throat in agony? The work is a response to the 1937 Disney film.
Is it going to be something like...
I don't know this. It's probably someone American, like, in 1940s, 50s.
Hopper, Rockwell, anyone.
Sounds funny for Hopper, doesn't it?
Try Rockwell, just... Oh, I mean, it sounds a bit...
Yeah, it sounds a bit kitschy, but, Rockwell.
It's Paula Rego.
Oh!
Magritte's 1964 painting, The Son of Man, depicts a besuited man whose features are obscured by an apple. Mm-hmm. What headgear is he wearing?
A bowler hat.
A bowler hat, of course. 10 points for this. Described in the Acts of the Apostles, the riot of the silversmiths took place in which ancient city, later the site of the Library of Celsus? The dispute was led by makers of miniature shrines to Artemis.
Reading Elmsley.
Ephesus.
Ephesus is correct. These bonuses are on a surname. Founded by an eponymous New Zealander who died in 1970, which Formula One team is based at Woking in Surrey?
McLaren
is correct.
Well done, yeah.
The British geneticist Anne McLaren pioneered advances that led to human IVF. For what form of fertilisation do the letters IV stand?
In vitro.
Correct. In the mid-1970s, the impresario Malcolm McLaren was an unofficial manager of what US band? Its lineup included David Johansen.
Sex Pistols.
The New York Dolls is what I was looking for.
Oh, sorry, they're the American.
10 points for this. Symbiotic Planet is a... And at the gong, Reading have 120, Imperial College London have 225. Well, Reading, you got off to a good start, but you faded a little bit. You were unlucky, I think, with how the questions fell. Congratulations, Imperial. You were a delight to watch as well. Great.
Thank you.
So Imperial College London take the first of the places in the semi-finals, and Reading University will have to fight again and win in order to qualify. I hope you can join us next time for another quarter-final match. But until then, it's goodbye from Reading University.
Goodbye.
It's goodbye from Imperial College London.
Goodbye.
And it's goodbye from me. Goodbye.